Yeah, good morning, everybody. Welcome back to the sixth hour. We have analyzed four problems. Let us see one more example. That is, analyze the continuous beam shown in figure by moment distribution method and to draw body moment diagram and shear force diagram. As usual, the first step, it is calculation of body moment. Now the first span AB, if you assume that as fixed, it is subjected to UDL throughout. Intensity is 3 kN per meter. The length is 4 meter. Now MF AB will be minus. This is A, this is B. It is W L squared by 12. That is minus. 3 is the intensity of UDL. Span is 4 squared divided by 12. And it is minus 4 kilonewton meter. Now MFBA, in the similar way, it is only plus WL squared by 12 and it will be plus 4 kilonewton meter. Now the second span is BC, it is subjected to UDL and a central point load, combination of UDL and point load. As usual, the intensity is 3 kN per meter, point load magnitude is 25 kN. Coming to the length of the beam, 4 meter. Now, MF BC will be minus. First, now fixed end moment at B and C is due to UDL and 25 kN point load. That is, if you take UDL first, minus WL squared by 12, that is 3 into 8 squared divided by 12. And due to point load, it is WL by H. That is 25 into 8 divided by 8. Totally, it is 41 kilonewton meter, MFBC. MFCB will be plus, due to UDL, 3, that is W into L squared, that is 8 squared divided by 12, plus due to point load 25 into 8 divided by 8. That is plus 41 kilonewton meter. Now next, the span is CD. CD is subjected to a point load of magnitude 16 kN at 1 meter and 3 meter distance. Now here MFCD will be minus W A B divided by W A B squared by L squared, that is minus W is 16 into A is 1 meter into B is 3, that will be squared, divided by L squared is 4 squared, that is minus MF CD is minus 9 kilonewton meter. Similarly, MF DC will be plus W A squared B divided by L squared. That is plus W is 16 into A squared is 1 squared into B is 3 divided by L squared. It is 4 squared. That is plus 3 kilonewton meter. Now lastly, it is DC. Now DC is an overhanging portion. DE. It is subjected to a point load at the free end. Therefore, MF DE will be minus 10 into 1, that is 10 kilonewton meter are the fixed end moments. That is what it is given here. Now the next is distribution factor. Now we have, as usual, join, and to that joint member connected, and K, that is stiffness factor, the sum of the stiffness factors and the distribution factor. It is K divided by sigma K. Joint B, there are two members, BA and BC. At joint C, again two members, CB and CD. And joint D, again DC and DE, the overhanging end. BA, A far end is inched, therefore it is 3EI. I for the fourth member or portion AB is 3I. If the far end is hinged, then it is 3EI by L. And coming to BC, it is an intermediate member, therefore 4EI is 10I. For the portion BC, moment of inertia is 10I divided by L. Therefore, sigma K will be the sum of these two. It will be 7.25EI. Coming to CB, CB is an intermediate member, therefore it is again 4E into moment of inertia for CB is also 10I divided by L, and for CD it is far end D is hinged support. Therefore, it is 3EI. It is 2I divided by L. Therefore, the total sum will be 6.5EI. Coming to DC. DC, it is an intermediate member. Therefore, it is 4E, I is 2I divided by L. And this DE is an overhanging portion. Therefore, it is 0 stiffness factor. And the sum will be 2EI. Therefore, distribution factor for the member BA will be this divided by 7.25. It will be 0.31. And for the member BC, this divided by 7.25, it will be 0.69. Similarly, if you calculate K by sigma K for the member CB, this divided by this, it will be 0.77. And for the member CD, distribution factor will be this divided by this. It will be 0.23. And for this, this divided by this will be same, 1, and it will be 0. This is the distribution factor for member BA, BC, CB, CD, DC, and DE. Now, this is shown in this table. Distribution factor calculation, what it is explained in the previous work. Now, next it will be the moment distribution table. For that, it is member AB, BA, BC, CB, CD, and DE and DE, DC and DE. The distribution factor what we have calculated for AB, BA, BC, CB, CD, and this. Now, FEMs we have calculated are MF AB is minus 4 kilonewton meter and MF BA is plus 4 kilonewton meter. MF BC is minus 41 and MF CB is plus 41. And MF CD minus 9, MF DC plus 10, 3. And this is minus 10. That is because of the overhanging portion. Now here we have to find the modified fixed end moment, because if you see A, it is an injured support. At this support, end moment should be 0, and at this support, end moment will be 10 into 1. Therefore, here by assuming A, fixed end moment is calculated as minus 4 kilonewton meter. That minus 4 kilonewton meter should be made balanced, or it is nothing but releasing the moment by 50% to the adjacent support. That means adding balancing plus 4, because at A it is an injured support, end moment will be 0. Therefore, making it 0 by balancing, and if you are balancing, that should be carried to the next end, that is by 50% plus 2. Now, here minus 10. Now, DE. Here, DC also should be same thing, that is plus 10 for balancing. Therefore, to make this 3 plus 10, that should be 7, plus 7 should be added. Therefore, end moment, final end moment will be plus 10. Again, if you are balancing it to minus 10, then that plus 7 balance to make this equal should be carried to the next end by 50%, that is plus 3.5. Therefore, initial moments or modified moment will be MAB will be 0. MFBA will be because of this carryover 4 plus 2, 6. And this is as it is minus 41 and this is plus 41. Now because of this carried over by 50%, 3.5, minus 9 plus 3.5, it will be minus 5.5. And this will be plus 10 and minus 10. Now this is finalized, this is finalized. Now with this bending moments, with this fixed end moments, again it should be balanced. You can see 6, 41. There is a lot of difference. 41 and 55. Therefore, that should be balanced and it should brought to the same, nearer to the approximation. Now these are the fixed end moments. Now we should forget these fixed end moments. For next calculation, these are taken as initial moments. Now, at B, this unbalanced moment is this difference here, that is minus 41 plus 6, minus 41 35. Now that 35 here is the unbalanced, is minus 35. Now therefore balance, it means plus 35. That plus 35 should be distributed to AB, BA and BC in the ratio of this distribution factor. That means 35 into 0.31, it is 10.85, that is 10.9, and this difference 35 should be distributed to this member BC with a distribution factor ratio of 0.69. 35 into 0.69, it will be 24.15, that is this 24.1. Similarly here, the difference, it is 41 minus 5.5. 41 minus 5.5. That 5.5 should be distributed, that is 35.5 should be distributed in the ratio, that is 35.5, and therefore unbalanced is minus 35.55. Now this should be into point, the distribution factor for the member CB is 0.77, will be equal to into 0.77, it is 27.3, that is minus 27.3, and to this side, that is for the member CD, it is 35.5 into 0.23. This will be 35.5 into 0.23, 8.165, that is minus 8.2. That is what you can see here, that is 27.3, this one minus, and by this 8.2. That is unbalanced moment is distributed to these two members in the ratio of distribution factor. Now this should be carried to here by 50%, that is half of that 12.1, and this should be carried to here, that is minus 13.7. Now 13.7 and 0. Therefore, unbalanced will be plus 13.7. Now plus 13.7 should be distributed. To this, with a ratio of 0.31, it will be plus, that is 13.7 into 0.31, it is 4.2, that is plus 4.2, and this will be into 0.69, that is 13.7 into 0.69, 9.5, that is plus 9.5. This 4.2 and 9.5 are here distributed, unbalanced. This unbalanced will be distributed to BA and BC with the ratio of distribution factor. Now coming to this here, 12.1. That 12.1, that is plus, is the unbalanced. To balance it, it is minus 12.1, that is minus 12.1. The next step, that should be with this ratio, means minus 12.1 into 0.77, it will be 9.3, that is minus 9.3. And with this ratio, means it is 12.1 into 0.23, it will be 2.78. That means minus 2.8. That you can see here, that is this one. Minus 9.3, that is minus 12.1 into 0.77, and minus 12.1, that is balanced moment, into 0.23, that is minus 2.8. Now this 9.5 should be distributed by 50% to this joint, that is 4.8. this should be distributed to here, minus 4.7. now again, unbalanced moment is plus 4.7. that plus 4.7 should be distributed to this BA and BC in the ratio of this distribution factor, that is 0.31 and 0.69. we get 1.5 and say 3.2. similarly here, unbalanced moment is minus 4.8. that minus 4.8 should be distributed to this by the ratio of distribution factor 0.77, and for this it is with a ratio of 0.23, that is minus 1.1. similarly, that should be carried here, 50%, this should be carried. Now unbalanced moment is plus 1.9. plus 1.9 should be distributed with a distribution factor of 0.31, it will be 0.6, and plus 1.9 to this with a ratio of 0.69, it will be 1.3. now here plus 1.6, it is unbalanced, is minus 1.6. minus 1.6 should be distributed to the CB with a ratio of 0.77, that means minus 1.2, and this will be minus 0.4. and this 50% here, 50% here. Now again, unbalanced here, plus 0.6. 0.6 should be distributed to these two member in the ratio of 0.31 and 0.69, is this value. Here unbalanced is 0.7. sorry, therefore to balance it is minus 0.7. Minus 0.7 should be distributed to this 0.5 and to this 0.2. Now this should be carried by 50%. This is by 50%, that is this much. Now again balancing, it is coming to very very small value, therefore we can stop here. After balancing 0.3 plus 0.3 to here with a ratio of 0.31, to this with a ratio of 0.69, and this 0.2 minus 0.2 to this with a ratio of 0.77, and minus 0.2 to this minus 0.5. Now if you add this, it is 0, because MAB A is an integer support, it is 0 only. Now to get MBA, the sum of this 6, 10.9, 4.2, 1.5, all these things, it is 23. Now adding all this, it is minus 23. Adding all this, it is this, and finally here it is plus 10 and here it is minus 10. Therefore final end moments are MAB 0, MBA plus 23.49, MBC is minus 23.49, and MCB is plus 18.25, MCD is minus 18.25, and MDC is plus 10, and MDE cantilever, it is minus 10 kilonewton meter. Now after the end moments, we should draw the fixed end moments, Benny moment diagram. Now to draw Benny moment diagram, this is the beam A, B, C, D, E. Now here, due to UDL, it is a parabola. This will be W L square by H. That is maximum bending moment if a beam is subjected to UDL. That is W, and L is 4 and divided by 8, we will get 6 kilonewton meter. That is the simple bending moment due to loading. Coming to this, it is subjected to a point load and UDL. Therefore, net bending moment diagram will be a parabola again, and this will be a parabola. This will be W L squared by H, that is due to UDL, and W L by 4, that is due to point load, maximum bending moment, you will get 74. Now here it is a triangular load. Therefore, it is a triangle, and this will be maximum W AB by L. A is 1 meter, B is 3 meter, W is 16. Therefore, you will get maximum bending moment as 12. Lastly, that is the overhanging portion, that is D E C B and A. Now to draw the end moments, now these are the bending moment diagram due to load, nothing but simple bending moment diagram. Now we should superimpose the bending moment diagram due to end moments, that is final end moments, as calculated in the moment distribution table. Now MAB, it is 0. MBA, it is here. We got 23.49. It is minus 23.49. Mark it above. That is 23.49. Join that to the previous point. Now, again here minus 23, plus 23.49, and at this point it is 18.25, somewhere here. This is the straight variation, and here it is 18.25, and here 18.25, here it is 10, that is here 10. Join that to the previous point, and it is 0. Now this is the net bending moment diagram. It is positive, this is negative, this is positive, and this is negative, positive, and negative. That is the net bending moment diagram. If you want to draw, it is not asked. If you want to draw, elastic curve will be this. Up to this, it is sagging. Here, it is sagging. That is concavity upward. Now here it is a support, and up to this it is hugging. Therefore beam should line stay at support only. That means it will be like this. It is hugging. Now up to here it is sagging. It bends. It is a very smooth curve. Here it is sagging. Now it should go through this, and up to this it is hugging. That is hugging. Now up to that, it is sagging. Now the remaining is full hugging. That means it will go like this. Hugging. That is the elastic curve. That blue color is due to end moment. Black is due to simple bending moment due to loading, and imposing you will get the net bending moment diagram. Looking into the nature of the bending moment, net bending moment, we can draw elastic curve like this. Now to draw shear force diagram, we should calculate the support reactions. For the calculation of the support reaction, here it is RA and RB. Say 1. Because reaction at B is due to the member B Pc also, or B2. The total reaction will become RB1 plus RB2. Similarly, at C also, RC1, RC2, and here RD. And due to this, RD2, that is due to this 10 kilonewton and a moment, that is 1 meter. Now here, this is with a load of 16 kilonewton, and this is with UDL, this also with UDL, and a central point load. That is 25, and this is 3, this is 3. Now coming to the end moments, these are the, if you draw free body diagram of AB, BC, CD, and DE. Now these are due to the loads. Now we have calculated the end moments also, MAB, 0 here, MBA, it is plus, therefore it is clockwise, 23.49, here it is anti-clockwise, 23.49, here it is plus 18.25, it is clockwise, MCB. 18.25, and here minus 18.25. It is plus 10, and here it is minus 10. Now these are the loadings or free body diagram of different portions in that beam. Now just for this, if you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0, Ra plus Rb1 will be equal to 3 into the span, it is 4 meter. 3 into 4, that means 12. Call this equation number 1. Now sigma Ma is equal to 0. If you apply sigma Ma is equal to 0, Ra will be 0, then about A, this UDL creates clockwise, therefore plus 3 into 4 into its perpendicular distance is 4 by 2, that is 2, minus Rb1 into its distance is 4, and this, it is a clockwise moment, plus 23.49 is equal to 0. No perpendicular distance for a moment. Therefore, from this, we will get RB1 as 11.87. Substitute here, you will get RA 0.13 kilonewton. Similarly, by considering the equilibrium of this portion BC, applying sigma Fy and sigma MC, you will get RB2 as 15.16 and RC1 as 23.84 and RC2 as 14.06. and RD1 as 1.9, and this is 10 kilonewton. Now, if you apply sigma Fy is equal to 0, this 10 and 10 are equal and opposite, 10 kilonewton. Therefore, this RC will be the sum of these two, RD will be the sum of these two, and RB is the sum of these two. If we get, we'll get the reactions and we can draw the these are the free body diagram. By applying equilibrium condition, we can calculate and we can draw shear force diagram. RA is plus 0.13, go up. Assuming that there is no UDL, go horizontally and go down by an amount equal to 3 into 12, that is minus 12, that means minus 12 and 0.13, it is 11.87. From here, you go up by an amount equal to the reaction RB, and here, assuming that no UDL, you go down by an amount equal to 3 into 1, that is 3, and you will join previous point here by an amount equal to 25, and this, like this, you can complete the shear force diagram. This is the complete solution for this problem, that is drawing shear force diagram, bending moment diagram, and elastic curve also that I have shown here. Yeah, I have shown elastic curve also to draw. Okay, now that is the solution of this problem. That is calculation of FEMs, distribution factor, and moment distribution table, support reactions by considering the free body diagram of the different portions, and bending moment diagram and shear force diagram, that is the complete solution for this problem. Now we'll go to next problem. This is another typical problem wherein settlement is dealt. That is, analyze the continuous beam shown in figure by moment distribution method and draw the bending moment diagram. Support B here, this is the loading of the beam. Given, support B sinks by 10 millimeter, and E should be taken this and I should be taken this. Now here, A and B are not at same level. B and C are also not at same level. Therefore, fixed end moments for the member AB and BC are not only due to the external loading, and they are due to the settlement also. That formula I have explained in the first or second hour itself. That is, due to settlement, FEM is given by 6 EI delta by L square. Now, we will calculate the fixed end moment first. Now, this is AB. Loaded with UDL. 20 kilonewton per meter. The span is 6 meter. Now here, MFAB will be minus W L square divided by 12. In addition to that, it is also due to the settlement. Now, The support B sinks by 10 millimeter. Now here B is below the support A and it is to the right side. If that is the case, due to settlement, it is minus 6 EI delta divided by L squared. That is minus this. This calculation minus 6 into E. Young's modulus is given as 2 into 10 raised to the power of 5 into moment of inertia is given as 1.2 into 10 raised to the power of 1.2 into 10 raised to the power of minus 4 into delta is given as 10 divided by L squared, it is 6 squared. Now this should be converted into 600 square, 6000, that is length. Now this minus 60 here, by substituting length in meter and this intensity in kilonewton and meter combination, but here Young's modulus is in newton and millimeter, moment of inertia is in millimeter raised to the power of 4, and this is also in millimeter. Therefore, this should be converted into newton, kilonewton and meter unit. That means 10 raised to the power of 12 divided by 10 raised to the power of 6. That will be minus 60, minus 40. If you calculate this, it is minus 120 kilonewton meter. 60 and 40, 100 kilonewton meter. Minus 60, minus 40, it is minus 100 kilonewton meter. See, right support is below. Therefore, fixed end moment due to settlement will be minus 6 EI delta divided by L squared. It is minus 60, 40. That is minus 100 kilonewton meter. Coming to MF BA, it is plus 20 into 6 square divided by 12. And due to sinking, here the support is B, it is A is above, left support is above with respect to the right support, means it is again minus 6 EI delta, that is the sign convention, divided by L squared. This will be minus 60 and this will be plus 60 and minus 40, it will be plus 20 kilonewton meter. That is due to loading and due to sinking of the support B, that is minus 6 EI delta by L squared. Now next is the portion BC. BC is this. It is subjected to a point load 3 and 2, 50 kilonewton. That is BC. Now here, MF BC, again here, B sink by 10 millimeter means with respect to C, the position of B is somewhere here. That is 10. Therefore, here also, fixed end moments will be due to loading and also due to the settlement. Due to loading means it will be minus W AB squared by L squared. That is the formula. That is for eccentric loading. And plus due to this plus 6 EI delta by L squared. Now here, with respect to B, C is at higher level, above B level. Therefore, if we are going towards that higher level, it is plus. That means minus W into W is into A, it is 3 into B squared, it is 2 squared divided by L squared, it is 5 squared plus it is 6, same thing. This will be minus six. E will be same, I will be same, delta will be same. Only span will be different. That is, L will be 5 squared, and the conversion you will get minus this value is minus 24, and this will be plus 57.6, and that will be plus MFCB. MFBC. It is 33.6 kilonewton meter, and MF CB will be same plus 24 and plus this 57.6. This will be plus 50 into 3 squared into 2 divided by 5 squared प्लस 6 इंटू ई, 2 इंटू 10^5 इंटू 1.2 इंटू 10^-4 इंटू 10 इंटू 10^12 डिवाइडेड बाय 5000 स्पैन होल स्क्वायर इंटू 10^6 इट विल बी एम एफ सी बी विल बी प्लस 93.6 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. And lastly, this CD it is UDL 20 kilonewton per meter, span is 4 meter, and this MFCD will be minus W L squared by H, that is minus WL squared by 12 fixed head moment, that is minus 26.67 kilonewton meter, and MF DC will be plus 26.67 kilonewton meter. Now fixed head moments are calculated here. Now the remaining procedure will be same, that is distribution factor BA, A is fixed, therefore 4EI by L, BC is an intermediate member, therefore 4EI by L, and C, CB is an intermediate, that is 4EI by L, and CD, D is an injured support, therefore 3AI by L, and this is sigma k, and DF k by sigma k, and this one, and the distribution factors. Now moment distribution table, again here releasing of joint is required because joint D is injured support, therefore end moment will be zero, but if you assume joint D as fixed end moment, fixed end, we get fixed end moment as 26.67, and therefore that should be balanced, minus 26.67 and zero, and that should be carried here, and initial moment or modified moments are calculated here. Then balancing, the balancing 20 and 33.6 will be plus 53.6 plus 53.6. Balancing means minus 53.6 should be balanced and distributed to this BA and BC with this distribution factor ratio. Similarly, here unbalanced moment is 93.6 minus 40.01. And to balance it, it will be minus the difference, and that should be distributed to year and year, and that should be carried over here because it is a fixed end moment. Here it is carried over and balanced. Again, this will be balanced, should be distributed here. This should be balanced plus 13.7, distributed here and distributed here, and balance and carry over. We can do it for few iterations, and finally end moments will be the sum of this. That is the final end moments, and we can draw Bending moment diagram as usual by drawing the bend moment diagram due to end moments and superimposing the end moments over the simple bend moment diagram, we will get this, the net bend moment diagram. Okay, this is the bend moment diagram. We can draw shear force diagram also by considering the different members, free body diagram. And elastic curve also. Okay. Now here only change is calculation of fixed end moments and due to end moments with proper due to sinking with proper sign convention using the formula 6EI delta by L squared. Remaining procedure will remain same. Okay. Can practice if you have any doubt. In the calculation of FEM due to sinking, we'll discuss in the next class. I think these six problems are enough on continuous beams. In the next class, we'll go for the analysis of the frames. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.